Welcome to the overview of the TechTrade availability course. In the next few minutes, I will show you the purpose of this app. First of all, let's take a look at some highlights. What is this app meant for? Well, mainly to get a visual insight of the availability of your products. Every company that ships goods knows that stock information is key. And you want to have this information by less clicking. Standard functionality in BC, like the item availability by period, this functionality is great, but you don't want to use this functionality for every line in the order that you're registering. So we integrated this functionality in sales orders, assembly orders, and transfer orders. And if you do assembly to order, you will get a visual indication of the availability of the materials in your assembly order, and you will get this information already in your sales order line. The system works data-oriented or uses a gross calculation. It's up to you. You can use a setting for this. Many companies just ship the goods as soon as the order is entered and the stock is available because their customers want to have the goods as soon as possible. But if your company is more like project oriented and your customers order goods and they want to receive them in like 4 or 5 weeks, you will probably work data oriented and you will use a requested shipment date and stuff like that. Then you can have the system working date oriented, so it uses a date calculation to see if the stock is available on the requested date. The app is ideal for shipping as well. Most SMB organizations will not use the WMS system, the warehouse management system. So you will probably not use the pick or the warehouse shipments. So if you post the shipments directly from the sales orders, you can use this functionality as well, and you will get an overview of the orders that have some lines to ship. Well, enough talking. Let's switch to the Business Central, and I will show you how it works in the sales orders. So I will open up a sales order. And in this sales order, I have a few lines. And here in these lines, you see the availability indicators. You see the different colors that I used. The first line depicts a structure diagram. And what this means, it's red. So it's telling me that we are short on some materials in this related assembly order, which means that we do not have enough stock to assembly 3 items. Now, if I want to see what items are short, I can go to the assembly order. I open up the entire order, and we see the visual indications of the availability of these goods. You see most lines are green, so we have enough stock for these, and we see a few lines that have a red green indicator, so this means that they are partially on stock and still some stock is missing and we have to purchase them or whatever. So they are not purchase order created yet or not enough, because you see it's red, so we still have to do something. Now, when I go back to the sales order, you see some more indicators. We see the front wheel in this order is green, and that means that we have plenty of stock, we are safe, we can deliver those goods to the customer, independently of other sales order or other demands in my system. We are always safe with the current data. Next line, you see a red indicator. So that means we do not have enough stock and we do not have enough purchase order or incoming goods to deliver this item to the customer. And we can have a combination of those two. And that's what we see in the next line. We have a red-green indicator. So there's stock available, but we still have to purchase or assemble items to ship these 100 brakes to the customer. And in the last line, we see a combination of orange and green. That means there's some stock, but not enough. But we still ordered goods. So if everything is goes according to plan and the vendor ships the goods on time, we should have enough stock to deliver this item to the customer. So this is in the sales order. Beside the sales order, I already told we have these indicators in the assembly orders as well. I already showed you that. And the same is valid for the transfer orders. So I go to the transfer orders now. Transfer orders. So I have a transfer order in the system here. And here you see the same indicators with exactly the same functionality. And we see that the first line is available for shipping. The second line, well, we still need some stock for this. So these are the indicators in the orders. Besides these indicators in the orders, I already told you about the shipment planning. So I will open up the shipment planning page. This is a very nice page for your personnel in the warehouse, for them to see what items, what orders can be shipped. In the top of the screen, you see the order headers. So these are all the orders that are currently in the system. And you see the indicators here in this part of the page. If there's a red square shown, that means that there are some lines that contain the red icon. If they're green, well, then there are lines that contain some green. So if I only have a green icon, it means I can ship something. And that is indicated by the last column, if there's something available to ship at this moment. Well, the first order, you see only a green indicator. That means that for all the lines are green in this order. So I've selected this order. And in the bottom of the page, it shows me the lines of this order. And you can see that all lines in this order are green. That in contrast to the last order. If I click on the last order, then you see in the top of the page that we have all colors available. So red, orange, and green. And you see this in the lines as well. We have red, orange, as green in this in the lines. If we want to ship something, it is possible. You see the shipping advice of these orders. This is shown here as well. And you see partial shipping is allowed. So we do have some green lines. This we could ship something at this moment. That is depicted by, it's a bit hard to see, but it's a truck, a green truck. So if there's a green truck, it means you can ship something at this point in time. Well, I only have a few, like 10-ish orders at this moment, so it's not so hard to get an overview on this. But like in a real-life situation, you will probably have like 100, 200 simultaneous orders outstanding. And then you want to see the orders that you can ship at this point in time. So we added a function for that. So you can filter on orders that only have something to ship. So if I click on that, you will see that the order 18 will disappear because there's nothing to ship in this order. There you go. So with this filter, you can you get a visual overview of the orders that have something to ship. And if you want to ship the order, you can modify the amount you want to ship. So like if I want to ship this front wheel, I can enter the quantity to ship here, or like I can, maybe I want to delete the quantity ship of the order lines. So let's do that. And you can use the setting to fill this quantity or not in the sales settings. Now, if I would post this order, it will only ship the front wheel, and I can post it from this page as well. So if I use the post button here, I can post and print, and I can print the packing note. And the delivery node, I mean. And this front wheel will be shipped to the customer. So this page is a very handy page that reduces the time of filtering and looking into individual orders in the system. And prevents salespeople of printing out orders and bringing them to the warehouse to indicate which orders can be shipped. So it's now up to the warehouse personnel to use this page and to see which orders can be shipped. We added some indicators here as well. It shows the last shipment date of the individual lines, so that you know at what date the order should be shipped. Well, I think there was a short overview. If you want to see more, or if you want to test the app, just visit the app on the app source, download it, and you can try it for free.